conventional sources of energy. The conventional sources of energy is that energy which are available in abundant in earlier days. But now today, we are focused towards this conventional sources of energy, towards this non-conventional sources of energy. So here it will discuss something that how the difference between the conventional sources of energy and non-conventional sources of energy. And in case of conventional sources of energy, these sources of energy are not abundant, present in limited quantity, whereas non-conventional sources of energy, these are abundant in nature. Conventional sources of energy can be used for a long time, but now we are using the non-conventional sources of energy. The conventional sources of energy are basically the non-renewable sources of energy, but in case of non-conventional resources of energy, they are renewable sources of energy. And here I am discussing with you some difference between the conventional sources of energy and the non-conventional sources of energy, that how this conventional as well as the non-conventional sources of energy can be, you can say that differentiate with each other. So these are some, you can say that the few examples of conventional resources of energy and the non-conventional sources of energy. As I have already tell you that the conventional sources of energy are known as renewable energy and non-renewable energy. So in the past years, we can use this non-renewable of sources of energy, like we can use fossil fuel, we can use coal, we can use natural gases, we can use nuclear fuels. But nowadays, the time will come when we are focused towards the renewable sources of energy or the non-conventional sources of energy. And the chief sources of these non-conventional sources of energy are like solar energy, biomass energy, wind energy, geothermal energy, and hydropower energy. So one thing that I must tell you to all, that you all know that the non-renewable sources of energy are basically those sources that they can deplete our, you can say that ozones, or they can pollute our atmospheres. But in case of renewable sources, you can say that these are non-pollutant. The very, very most important thing that we must appreciate on this common platform, that the renewable sources of energy is used because of non-pollutant. And also these renewable sources of energy are plenty of quantity are available in this day. So the very first quote in case of energy, we must quote it, that the energy is not an idea, it's an execution. Now the time will come when we have to save our energy. The time will come when we have to conserve this energy, because if we not conserve our energy today, the future generation cannot have some type of energy. I will just give an first example, that if you go a 10 year or 20 years back, in our locality, there are two or three or four houses. And in that two or three or four houses, I think there is only one or two air conditioner will be installed. But now the time will change. Nowadays, in our locality, we have 10 or 20 or 30 houses. And in every houses, there are not more than two. You can say that in particular houses, there are more than two or three ACs. So you can see, if you go beyond 10 years back, in 10 years back, your consumption rate of electricity is very, very low. But now your consumption rate of electricity is very, very high. And if we continue in this same process, the time will come when we have no energy. So now we have get an idea that we have to conserve the energy so that our future generation get energy. And for that thing, we are using energy conservation. Now, in this talk, I has an attempt made in this webinar to reveal the role of energy measures adopted for the conservation of energy in domestic sector in order to conserve the energy. Energy consumption or a demand generally refers to the term energy management, which means saving of energy. So in this talk, I concise the report in the field of energy management in domestic sector and act as an important tool for the technical persons in providing insight into the field of energy conservation and energy management. Now you can see in my presentation, after some time, you can see when you adopt a simple measures, you can conserve the energy. And this conservation of energy helps in saving the wastage of energy and raw material that we use in our domestic sector. Before discussing how this energy conservation will be done, the most and most important law that is governing with the transformation of energy, that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, but it can be transferred from one form to the another form. So in energy conservation, it is the practice of decreasing the quantity of energy used while achieving a similar output at the end of the use on a larger scale. Energy conservation is an element of energy policy. I must tell you one thing, that it should be seen that one unit of electricity saved is equal to 3 to 4 units of electrical generated. Because you all know that in today's scenario, our consumption rate of electricity is very, very high, but our generation rate of electricity is very, very low. And you must be known that about of 70% of energy generation in terms of, you can say that electricity, over 70% of electricity is wasted in transmission and distribution losses. So out of that 100%, only we can get a 30%. And if we not use that 30% energy in an efficient way, the time will come when there is no energy. So it's the time to save the energy for our future generation. And how we can save the energy for our future generation, it is only and only done by with the help of energy conservation techniques. The one of the most important thing that we can must kept in mind while energy conservation is that cheap and substandard gadgets consume more power as compared to expensive standard gadgets and prove to be costlier on a longer run. No doubt, your cheap and substandard gadget has initial cost is low, but if you talk about its running cost, its cost will be very, very high as compared to your standardized, you can say that, gadgets. Consideration should be given to the life cycle cost rather than the capital cost while purchasing any of the gadget. And so these are the certain points that you should keep in mind while we're doing energy conservation. It should be always kept in mind that electricity saved is basically a money saved. That if you save in electricity, you can ultimately save your money. So this is the basically the pie chart or a graph in which you can see the consumption pattern of electrical energy in Indian domestic sector. So in domestic sector, we are using our electrical energy for just a space heating, for water heating, for cooking purpose, for lightening purpose, and we are using this electricity for appliances. So you can see on this pie chart, the maximum and maximum contribution is to the appliance, and the appliance will be equals to 55%. Whereas your space heating is required 24%, water heating requires 5%, cooking requires 4%, and your lightening provides 12%. So the major area that you can say that you can conserve the energy is the area of your appliance. So this is basically the chart for the potential of renewable power in India, where we have so much power of renewable energy available. Only and only we have to get this power, get it. For example, if you see, we have Karnataka 12% share, J&K 7% share, Gujarat has 14% share, Andhra Pradesh has 8%, and this is basically a state-wise estimated potential of a renewable power, from where you can take renewable power in any of the contexts, like in solar, like in wind, like in tidal, like in any of the form. So this is a total, you can say that, the renewable power estimate potential in our India. So coming to my original talk on the concise report, that energy conservation, what do you mean by this energy conservation? Energy conservation is the effort made to reduce the consumption of energy by using less of an energy service. This can be achieved either by using energy efficient, that is using less energy for constant service, or reducing the amount of service used. So before telling to energy conservation, I must tell you that energy conservation is basically a technique. In that case, you can conserve the energy. So when you conserve the energy, there are two important things that you should keep in mind, that energy can be conserved by the two ways. Number one way, you are using replace original equipments with your energy efficient equipment so that they can consume less energy. And second thing, you can adopt some optimization technique in order to save the energy. So out of these two techniques, you can save your energy to a greater extent. The various principles involved in energy conservations are optimal control, optimized capacity, optimized load, use efficient processes, reduce losses, energy contaminating, examine energy conservation opportunities, energy storage facilities. So by adopting any of these techniques, you can conserve your energy to a greater extent, and you can help out that how this energy can be conserved. Now, before you can say that, in order to gain advanced version that how this energy conservation can be done, I will just tell you about a case study. I had done energy audit in some grid station, and in this presentation, I will show you that how when I adopt these energy conservation measures, your energy can be conserved. What was the existing and what was I proposed that your energy can be saved. So I think with this case study, you can get a better idea that how this energy can be conserved. So for the energy conservation, the area chosen for energy conservation is 220 by 132 by 33 kV burn grid station, which is about 25 kilometers away from Jammu. So it is basically a receiving station where we can receive the power from any of the generating station, and after that it can be distributed to the another ends. This is a brief introduction about the power, the area where I have done energy audit. The grid station has a capacity of 320 MVA power to the Jammu province, and these are all. Now, this is the switchyard of that burn grid station where I have done my energy audit. And in this presentation, you can see that how we can save the energy. I just simply put on normal techniques. I just simply put on four measures, and you can see after the four measures, you can save your energy in a greater extent. So this is basically the control room of your burn grid station, from where all the control processes related to the electricity can be done. Now, in this, I adopt energy conservation techniques in the control room as well as residential quarters of 220, 132, 33 kV burn grid station. I do one thing that I have only taken the two areas. The number one area, I had taken the control room, and second, I had taken the area residential quarters of that grid station. I can done energy conservation on that particular areas, and you see after that how this energy conservation can be done. Now there are one control room and 12 residential quarters, and in all that having 51 incandescent lamps having wattage of 100 watt. This is the first load that they are initially installed or proposed, with 48 FTLs, that is fluorescent tube lights, having wattage 55 watts, 63 high pressure mercury vapor lamps, and 11 computers with a wattage of 44. So out of all the load, I took this load for energy conservation, because the one of the most important principle behind the energy conservation, to conserve the energy, first of all, you have to get a preliminary report that in which area you have to get your energy conservation. So according to preliminary report, I have focused that I will done an energy audit in control room and 12 residential quarters, and the total load will be, we have 51 incandescent lamp with the 48 FTLs, 63 high pressure mercury vapor lamps, and 11 computers having wattage of 40 watts. So I proposed these four energy conservation measures. First of all, replacing of incandescent lamp with compact fluorescent lamps, CFL, replacement of 40 watt FT12 FTL having 15 watts magnetic blast, 36 watt FTL having 4 watts electronic blast, replacement of high pressure mercury vapor lamp with high pressure sodium vapor lamp, and replacement of existing monitors LCDs with light emitting diodes, that is LED monitor. And you see, by adopting these techniques, we can conserve energy. I will just tell you one thing, that this is basically the audit that I had done 2 or 3 years back. Now the technology has changed. Now today's we are taking two instead of CFLs, we are taking LEDs, so we can conserve energy to a more and more greater extent. But this energy audit I had done around 2 years back, so that is why we are using incandescent lamp with replacement the CFL. But now if I have to done energy audit, or anybody here present have to get energy audit, in this preliminary report is having a CFL, and that CFL will be replaced by LED. So if I adopt the first major, you can see first major has a very small investment with a payback period of 1 month. Second is also having a small initial investment with a payback period of 1 year. Third one having a little bit investment, but a payback period of 1 year. And your fourth one has a large investment required because you have to replace your LCD monitors with your LED monitors. So in that case, your payback period will be a more than 3 years. So I will just give you a case study that how this energy I can save. So I have already told you that ECM1 replacing of incandescent lamp with CFL compact fluorescent lamp. So there are 51 incandescent lamp installed in a grid station, which I recommended to replace with 20 watt CFL. So you see, present voltage is equals to 100 watt incandescent lamp with the number of units 51. So total voltage will be 5.10 kW. Proposed installation, I will tell that replace 100 watt CFL with 20 watt CFLs. So here we have 20 into 51 because the number will remain same. That is the amount, or you can say that the 51 incandescent lamp will be replaced by 51 CFLs. So the total number will remain same. Only the voltage will change from 100 watt to 20 watt. So the proposed installation watt is equals to 1.02 kW. So what is the reduced installation wattage? That is the reduced installation wattage will be 5.10 minus 1.20. That will be equals to 4.08 kW. So you can say that you can reduce this installation watt about 4.08 kW. Let us suppose that your incandescent lamp or CFL can work 10 hours in a day. So the total working hours will be 365 and the electricity rate is 4 rupees 4 per unit. So you can see after 1 year, your total expenditure will be about 60,000. That means about 59,568. So if you see our, you can say that our after 1 year, what is the electricity consumption bill? That will be around 60,000. Now, what is the initial investment required? That will be almost 120 per unit. That is 120 rupees of CFL into number of CFLs will be 51. That will be about 6,200. And you see that when I get its payback period, the payback period will be less than 1 year. That is around 38 days. So you can say that if you adopt this energy conservation measure number one, you can your payback period will be about 38 days. And after 38 days, you can get a good investment whatever you have invested in your change the energy conservation from your existing incandescent lamp to your CFLs. So here I will discuss that monetary saving per year, that is around 60,000. Initial investment required 6,200. Payback period is equals to 1 year. So this is all about. So you can see if you get a 51 incandescent lamp, your energy consumption is almost 18,615 kWh. But if you replace this incandescent lamp with your CFL, your consumption will be around 3,723 kWh. So you can see on this graph, initially when you having a 51 incandescent lamp, your energy usage, or you can say that energy, is basically 18,615. And when you replace this 51 incandescent lamp having wattage of 100 watt with only 51 CFLs with 20 wattage, you can see you can save your energy about 3723. So you can just correlate that. After that, you can save energy up to 6 times. Just only replace of your existing incandescent lamp with your CFL, you can save your energy almost 6 times. I think it is clear to all of you. Shall I proceed next?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So this was about the first ECM that I have adopted, and after that, see that I save the energy almost 6 times. If I say your existing will be 8,615, and if you propose, it will be around 3,723. Now, in the similar way, if you talk about replacement of 40 watt T12 FTLs having 50 watt magnetic blast with 36 watt T8 FTLs with 14 watt electronic blast, same methodology, same idea, same technique I have adopted. While I can say that in case of your simply in case of your fluorescent lamp, the same technique that I have also adopted. And you can see that in that case, your payback period is almost 333 days. That is less than 1 year. And again, you can see your existing 48 T12 energy conservation having energy is 9636 kWh. But if you replace this by T8 FTL, it will be around 2628 kWh. So you can again see on this chart, when you go for existing your FTLs, your energy consumption is almost equal to 10,000. But if you talk about your proposed, in proposed you have get about almost you can say that 2628. So here you can say that you can conserve the energy up to 3 times. So it is understood to all of you that how we can save this energy. So if you see, if I go for the ECM second, so ECM second, you can save energy, but only I have changed the existing your T12 FTL 15 watt magnetic blast with your T8 14 watt magnetic blast. Okay, please understood to all of you. Can I proceed further? Can I proceed further?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So give me just a second. Just a second. I will continue. Just a second. Yeah, sorry. Actually, my laptop battery has just been drawn out, so I will get a charger. Sorry. So, shall I continue? It is audible to all of you?
Sir, we can continue.
Okay, thank you so much. So, in the same case, if I proceed towards your third ECM, and the third ECM says that if I replace the high pressure mercury vapor lamps with high pressure sodium vapor lamp, so in that case you can also save your energy. So again, I will follow or the same procedure, the same, you can say that the methodology, in that case we can save your energy. So here we have the energy achieved by replacing 250 watt high pressure mercury vapor lamp with 125 watt high pressure sodium vapor lamp. So you can save your energy. Again, I can follow the same technique, the same methodology, that we have a 63 high pressure mercury vapor lamp having wattage will be 250. So installed wattage is 15.75 kW. I can replace this with 63 number of same units with 125 high pressure sodium vapor lamp. So we have 7.875 kW. So the reduced installation is about, you can say that 7.875. Again, this all these mercury vapor lamps or your sodium vapor lamps working for 10 hours in a day, and the total we have 365 days. So you can see after 1 year, your electricity bill is almost, you can say that 1,14,975, and the initial investment required is almost 1,26,000. So you can see when you use high pressure mercury vapor lamp, your energy conservation is almost about 58,000 kWh. And when you change this high pressure mercury vapor lamp with high pressure sodium vapor lamp, you can have an energy about 28,743. So again, we have this bar chart, and here you can see your payback period is not, you can say that less than 1 year, but now your payback period is greater than 1 year, but you can save this energy to a greater extent. Now, in this case, almost you can say that you can save the energy, or you can conserve the energy, you can say that double. So existing, it says that it is almost about 58,000, but proposed you have almost about 29,000. So by adopting this type of energy conservation measure, you can again save the energy to a greater extent. So this is a basically the ECM4 that I had adopted in that grid station. And if you go for the ECM4, that is energy conservation measure 4, in that case, what I have proposed that you can replace your LCD monitors with your LED monitors. And so these are certain things that if you replace your LCD monitors with LCD monitors, so what are the great benefits from that thing? Space required will be less, current drawn will be less, no load on AC will be less, smaller rating of UPS can be used, and all those. So if I talk about in the terms of energy conservation, if I talk about in the terms of energy, you can set saving. Again, you can see again the same technique, all the same processes I can adopt, all the numerical things I have adopt. And you can see your existing 11 LCD monitors, your energy consumption is almost about 3854, that is 3854. But if you proposed to replace these LCDs with your LEDs, you can having the energy about 1349. So almost you can say that it is double. So if you have the first existing energy conservation technique, that is LCD, you have almost 4000, you can say that kWh. And when you replace this with LEDs, so you can save the energy to a greater extent, or you can say that almost double time you can energy save. So coming to the part, if you combine all these parameters, that is if you combine your ECM1, if you combine your ECM2 3 4, all if you combine, so you can see your ECM1 has a contribution about 11%, your ECM2 having contribution about you can say that 21%, your ECM3 is having a contribution about 4%, but your ECM4 is having a contribution of almost you can get 64%. So I or any of the energy auditor, when adopt these type of energy conservation techniques, so we can save energy. So this is just in case, I can simply say that it is just an idea. I have proposed just an idea to all the participants to be present there, that how the energy conserved. So in that case, what I have to do, I have simply replace the existing energy sources with some energy efficient sources. No doubt initial investment required is high, but after some time, your payback period is low. If the time will come, you can save the energy to a greater extent, because I had already tell you that energy save is basically a money save. Electricity save is basically the money save. So by adopting these techniques, you can save this energy. So when I talk about all these, this is the energy conservation technique that I had already tell you that by replacing the existing energy sources with energy efficient sources. And second technique that I have already tell you that there are two ways by which we can conserve the energy. Number one is replacement of your existing sources with energy efficient sources. And number two is basically you can adopt certain optimization techniques to order to conserve the energy. So here we have a general tips to conserve the energy in domestic sector. So in that case, we cannot, you can say that replace somehow the non-existing non-energy efficient sources with energy efficient sources. Here only you can adopt simple techniques so you can save this energy. So all the things are must be written down here, that how you can save your energy, or automatic devices can help in saving the energy. So you can use somehow, you can say that sensors, motion sensors, so with the help of that thing you can save energy. These are certain tips that we can use in case of room air conditioners, that how you can save the energy to greater extent. And Again, I will tell you, in that techniques, we are not replaced by your existing sources with some energy efficient sources. In that case, we are simply putting one or two, you can say that major, so that energy can be saved. I have also made one research paper on that thing that will be published in IGSTA journal. So I will share with you all the presentation as well as the journal link so that you can get a better idea. So these are some refrigerator. In case of refrigerator, how you can save this energy, that is, all these come under the category of your energy conservation in your domestic sector. Again, how you can conserve the energy by adopting simple measures, you can replace your not replaced by your original existing sources, you can save your energy to a greater extent. In every home, there are microwaves and electrical kettles. So in that case, you can save energy by just simply, you can say that, adopting measures like microwave saves energy by reducing the cooking times. One can save up to 50% on your cooking energy cost by using a microwave instead of regular ovens, especially for small quantities of food. And all these things will be you are adopting. And mind it, I will tell you, by adopting all these energy measures, you can surely and surely a lot of energy you can save. And ultimately, if I talk about in the terms of monetary, you can also save your money and also you can conserve the energy. So this is all about your computer systems, how you can save your energy in the terms of computers. When I talk about the computer systems, how you can save the energy in your computer systems. So as I had already tell you that I have published many of the articles in the research paper. So this is one of my article that I published now recently, that in 9th November 2020, that save energy, save world for future generation, today's demand, that I have already tell you in starting that. Today, it's the time to save the energy so that our future generation get an energy. So this is one of my article that I published in local newspaper. This is again of the second article that I published recently in 25th October 2020, where I have published an article that world is changing from conventional sources to the non-conventional sources. And here I can give a line that generation rate of energy is low, but the consumption rate of energy is increased day by day. So based upon this, you can say the tagline, you have to conserve the energy. You have to divert your conventional sources of energy towards the non-conventional resources of energy. So at the last, we have a conclusion. Energy conservation is a practice of decreasing the quantity of the energy used while achieving a similar output at the end of the use on a larger scale. Energy conservation is an element for energy policy. So here we have a tagline, and I must say to all the participants to be there, wherever I propose my seminar and wherever I get an idea to interact the peoples, I will always say, save energy, save world for our future generation. So before concluding, one of the quote that I will from my side, that life is an ice cream, just enjoy it before it melts. So thank you so much. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me. So this is all about from my side. So if you have tell anybody having any doubt, he or she can ask me. I will ready for that question answer round. So thank you so much. Before my concluding, thank you so much again, Dr. Benno, who has given me an opportunity to present my view about energy conservation domestic sector. And I must say one thing, that with a short span of time, it is not possible to cover all the topics to be there. So it is just an idea. It is just a case study that how energy can be conserved. I have also done many of the energy audits in many of the industries like Coca-Cola beverages, like I have done energy audit in some school buildings. I had done energy audit in some, some engineering colleges, I have energy done. So with this shortest span of time, almost of 1 hour. So it is not possible for me to deliver each and every topic that how this energy conserved. I hope you all get a small idea that how this energy can be linked with them. Thank you so much to all the participants who listen my presentations very, very carefully. I must appreciate to all. And before leaving this segment, if anybody having any question, he or she can ask me. Thank you so much. So anybody having any doubt related to that thing, it's just an attempt from my side. I hope you can all get benefited from that thing. If anybody having any doubt from my side, you can tell me, please. I think there is no question from any participant side. Okay, so thank you so much. Thank you so much, Dr. Benno, who are inviting me for this wonderful session, and all very good strength of participant can join. I must thank you, Dr. Benno, for giving me an opportunity to deliver my talk on this topic. And I must also thank you, Dr. Nazar Ali, who has introduced with me Dr. Benno. And I must thank you both, the Dr. Nazar Ali as well as Dr. Benno. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you very much, sir, for your valuable thoughts and sharing your insights on energy conservation and different techniques on how to save energy. So hope it will be helpful for each and every one of us in this new year. So I have a small recommendation for the participants. So we have shared this feedback link in the chat box. So kindly fill the feedback link to get the certificates. So I think it's a wonderful session to kickstart with this new year in the month of January. So our chief guest has shared his contact number also. So in case if you have any queries or any doubts related to energy audit, so and energy conservation, you can definitely try to be in contact with him. So next, it's time to deliver the vote of thanks. So next, I would like to invite Dr. M. Marceline Bano, who is the secretary of IET Kanyakumari Local Network and the vice principal of St. Xavier's Catholic College of Engineering, to deliver the vote of thanks. Over to you, sir.
Good morning. May I audible?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
So, respected Chairman, Dr. S. Joseph Javagasa, our first webinar, Chief Guest and Resource Person, Engineer Loganesh Talwar, our well-wisher and special guest, Dr. Nasir Ali, dear IET KKL and committee members, and my dear participants, very good morning and warm greetings from IET Kanyakumari Local Network. Also, belated Pongal greetings to everyone. Gratitude is the attitude that takes you to your altitude. I deem it my proud privilege to propose a formal vote of thanks for the contribution of every noble heart towards the success of today's event. I would like to say today's webinar is an amazing event. It is a national integration webinar from Jammu and Kashmir to Kanyakumari. So K2K, it's a well connection, as our GFR YP Vice Chairman told, in the new year, we have started a national integrated seminar from a person from Kashmir, and we people are listening from Kanyakumari, and many people are participating from Kashmir also. The students of our resource person, Loganesh Talwar. So really, it's a wonderful and very, very important national integration integrated unit. It's a webinar. I would like to thank everyone. Especially, I thank our resource person, Engineer Loganesh Talwar, for devoting time for us during this busy schedule. Indeed, your valuable sharing of your experience on energy conservation in domestic sector and various case studies on energy conservation, and you have done a lot of energy audits. With all experience, you shared lot of useful information, lot of studies. So this will go a long way to help and guide our young budding engineers to prioritize their role on energy conservation. Really very useful for everyone. And informative one also. So on behalf of IET Kanyakumari Local Network, we are very grateful to mention our heartfelt thanks to you, sir, Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. As you have already said, it's the yes, point of the national integration. I must thank you to all the participants to be present there. Thank you so much who have given me the opportunity. So it is just was an attempt. Hope all the students or as well as the participants can benefit from this. So thank you so much, sir, once again from my core of heart, sir. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Welcome and thank you, sir. Next, I would like to acknowledge our sincere, my sincere thanks to our Kanyakumari Local Network Chairman, Dr. S. Joseph Javagar. He is a founder chairman and last 2 years also he is guiding our Kanyakumari Local Network in a very right way. He also the principal of Arunachala College of Engineering for Women. With his guideship, the institution also developing in a very, very well way. We are very grateful for your nice welcome address and introduction about our Kanyakumari Local Network. So thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
I must also thank you, your sir Joseph, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for inviting me this for lecture. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. So also I wish to express my sincere thanks and gratitude to our young professional vice chairman, engineer Geoffrey Jace, working in AVL Limited, currently working in Bangalore, for his hard work to coordinate the event in a very successful manner, becoming a master of ceremony and introducing chief guest. So all the way he helped IET activities in a very smooth and successful way. So thank you very much, Jaffer. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. From also my side, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Yes, sir. Also, I thank all the committee members, especially Treasurer Judson, all the OIP team, all the office bearers, and all the members of Kanyakumari Local Network for their cooperation and supports. Now, this is very important to say word of thanks to all the participants. So I would like to thank each and every participants from academy, industry, from Kashmir and from Kanyakumari. So this is a very integrated event. Once again, I say thank you so much for your active participation. Once again, I thank each and every one present here. Thank you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So on behalf of Kanyakumari Local Network, once again, we thank everyone. So thanks the resource person, office bearers, and all the people. Once again, thank you so much. With that, we conclude our session. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much. Have a good day. We will meet on future or also some other time. Thank you so much, sir. Have a good day. Okay, thank you.